Hello, everybody. What is up? We're doing something a bit different today. We're going to take a look at this new MMO that was just released, Tree of Savior. Now, I had to pay for it because it is going to be free to play, but it is not quite yet. I think you can pay between like $10 and $60 to access the game a month early, or you can just wait till April 27th to play it, and then it's going to be free to play. Now, I don't know anything at all about this game, so we're going to try it together here. Alright, so we're going to jump straight into it. Server list, Europe, no. So our picks are Orsha or Klaipeda. Let's see. Which one? I like Klaipeda better, I think. Entering your team name. A team name represents all of your characters. It is a common name used within the game. Your team name can be changed later on. Well, I don't want to use Nexus because I want to name my character that, obviously. So, interesting names. First thing I see on my desk is a Google AdSense piece of paper. Okay, that's not a good name. How about Abyss? Because I have a copy of Tales of Abyss on my desk. We'll go Abyss. Oops, too many S's. That's pretty lame, isn't it? How about Abyssion? Sounds like a disease. Eh, we'll just keep Abyss. We can change it later. I already said. Oh, the name already exists. Okay. How about my old World of Warcraft name? Haha! I knew it wouldn't be taken. You've successfully changed your. Oh, select your character class. Archer, female. Archer, male. I'm not gonna lie, we'll probably end up picking Archer, but I want to see what the other ones are. Cleric male. Wizard male. Cleric female. Wizard male. Aw, you can't pick the dog? Swordsman female. Hear that? The dog can be a swordsman. So I'm gonna go ahead and assume that, like, these are pretty typical. Your clerics are your healers, your mages are your damage dealers, maybe swordsmen's are tanks, I don't know exactly anything at all about this game. So, we'll go with Archer male. Archer uses bows and various secondary equipment. Their specialties are long range and agile attacks. They have a high attack, low defense, low support, and they are pretty difficult to play. So, what I first learned... Let me rephrase that. What I first saw about this game is it really kind of reminds me of Ragnarok Online. Why is... Oh, I see. Okay. I was wondering why they were stop rotating! Okay, you're looking very androgynous right now. We need to give you more of a boyish haircut. Not too impressed by my ability to customize my character right now. Got like six different hairstyles that all look pretty androgynous. Okay, fine. Nexus, please for the love of God, do not be taken already. The game's only been out a day. We'll do Klaipeda. I don't know what the difference is. Oh yeah, okay, we good. Loading the intro. Really loading the intro, holy shit. Ah, no! The game froze! Oh, it didn't crash though. Okay, that's okay. Ooh, pretty. So, once again, I'm going to re-emphasize, I don't know anything at all about this game. I just thought it kind of looked cool, and that was it. So I spent the $30 or whatever to play it early. That is a bit loud, isn't it? Oh! Weird loading. So what's going on here? Besides a drop in frame rate. I hope that's not because I didn't set this game to run on my Nvidia card. I hope it didn't default to the Intel graphics. That would suck. So I imagine that's our Tree of Savior, hence the game name. I have no idea what's going on. Do you see it? Oh, I can press the space bar. This is the catastrophe that just already fell upon us. I did not read that right, but that is okay. But an even greater calamity is just beginning. The demons are after the light of salvation. At this rate, all life in the world will come to an end. Please help me. Goddess Lama is her name. Only you, only the Revelator can save the world. Oh. Please go to Claypeta. Peta. I don't even know how to say that. I know I'm saying it wrong. Please don't crucify me. And please, do everything you can to keep the light of salvation safe from the demons. Alright, will do, Goddess. Forgot your name already. Hey, that's us. So, recording software says I'm getting a constant 60 FPS, but it's not. I can already tell that's not happening. What the fuck is Jesus? Okay. Oh, this is our lodge thing. Oh, we got mail. Let's read it. Unstable service compensation notice. Greetings, saviors. Today we had some troubles with our launch. This is from the staff, so we were going to offer you some items as compensation. Premium, XP tomes. Oh, I get it. Okay, so I'm guessing these XP tomes are, just give you, increased XP for a while. These are enchant scrolls. Don't know what they do. Adds a random option to a hair or costume. Okay. Some tooltips would be nice, so I don't know what I... Last thing I want to do is throw this stuff away. Oh, okay. Yeah, there we go. Founder server, exclusive access 3. This gives us... Your DLC can be viewed. What is this, though? I don't know. Can I just leave that there? I don't really know what that is. Okay, whatever. So we have our character here. Select a channel. Don't know what the little dots mean. I imagine that's population, like 19. Or it could be latency. I don't know. Yeah, we'll stick. 2's a good number. We'll stick with that one. That's our character. Okay, that's stuff. I don't know what it is. Oh, God. This server is currently full. Queuing for entry. Alright, guys. I'll see you whenever we actually get in the game. Son of a bitch. Okay, so, as you can see now, we are in the game. And first thing you'll notice is I am level 22. And that's because I couldn't record the game straight off the bat. There was a reason for that, and that is the server kept crashing. So there's really no point in recording anything. However, the servers do seem to be a bit more stable, so I can at least show off some of the gameplay and a little bit of how the game actually works. Right now, we're in the game's first dungeon, and I don't remember what we're doing. We're purifying or some shit. But anyway, game works as you pretty much would expect it to. You click on an enemy, and it attacks, and you have your various abilities you can use. I started off as the archer class, but then I upgraded to the ranger class, which is pretty fun. I like it. Now, before I started recording, I was trying to use this, but it was not working because the server was lagging. So we'll see what happens. And it looks like the same issue, but we'll wait here a second. Oh, there it goes. Okay. So yeah, the servers are definitely not stable. And it didn't do anything. Ah, okay, there we go. So, we're gonna press the V to do something. I didn't read it. Something about a compass and finding missing parts. And we'll wait for the server to catch up. Okay, there it goes. So where are we going now? There it went. Okay, quest complete. Yep, the server is finicky at best. So, we're gonna have to deal with that right now, but I need to show some of the gameplay at least. And if you're wondering why the frame rate's so low, it's because this game is not very well optimized. When I'm not recording, I can get a frame rate of around 60 to 80. Unfortunately, that involves me going into the config files and manually editing, which doesn't allow me to alt-tab out of the game, so I can't start my video recorder. And for some reason, the hotkey I have set up to do so does not work, and I don't know why that is, but I will get it fixed before the next video. At least try to, at least. Okay, so where are we going? Looks like we're going down here. Odd thing about this game was the default keys to move are actually the arrow keys, so I had to rebind them to WASD and have it work like a typical game. It was kind of annoying at first. So now we click on this, wait for it, wait for it. There it goes. Okay. Do we need to use the compass again? The game says use the compass, but it will not let me use it. Which means we have some serious server lag. We can try switching the channel we're currently on and see if that works. We'll go channel 11. There aren't a lot of people on that one. From the looks of it, doesn't even look like it's going to let me do that. And now I can't attack enemies, and everybody's all kinds of fucked up. Yes, I would like to move to channel 11. And I thought the servers were being better, but obviously I was wrong. Oh, here we go. If I sound annoyed, it's because I am annoyed. A little bit. Okay, let's use the compass right away. See if we can't actually get it to work. It doesn't look like this channel is much better. I guess it wouldn't make sense to really hop channels. Yeah, nothing's happening. This is really starting to piss me off. Internet connection is absolutely fine, so it's definitely the game. Yeah, fucking hell, I can't even attack up there. It took forever, but it did work. Wow, isn't this amazing? Well, I'm not cutting the video again, because this is a first day impression, and this is what's happening on the first day. Okay, fucking hell. No, not doing anything. Use the compass. So we'll just sit here. Let's talk about some other things about the game. Here we go. We'll go on our character information. You got your 5 base stats: strength, constitution, intelligence. SPR, don't remember what it means, but it's used to increase your max SP, which is basically your magic points. Okay, look, it actually worked. And block penetration, magic defense, the most important two for an archer or a ranger are strength, which increases physical attack, critical attack, maximum carry weight, and dexterity, which increases accuracy, evasion, and critical raid. I put a couple of points into constitution because it increases your max HP. I haven't put anything into intelligence because I'm not a magic user. Okay, so... wait, what the fuck happened? Alright, well anyway, let's go into our class skills. Right now, I'm a ranger, I was an archer. These are my archer skills: swift step, multi-shot, full draw, oblique shot. Well, I can't upgrade them anymore, but I still have them to be available to be used. And the ranger... oh, I have a point ranger. I actually did not know that. So we will put it into one of these two. Fortunately, I don't know what the fuck critical shot does because the description's still in Korean, so... yeah, no idea. It fires an arrow with a high chance of critical at the target, but I don't... that's it. That's all I got to go off of because I don't read fucking Korean. And high anchoring, aim with the tip of your arrow and penetrate through enemies in front of you. We're going to take that one if it'll let me. not working, so now we need to wait for the server to do more shit. My compass didn't work. Yeah, whatever. Here's our inventory. We don't need a server to talk about this. As you can see, you can equip your various equipment, weapons, accessories. You know how it works if you played any other video game ever in your life. They increase your stats. You know, accessories give you little perks that, whatever. You know how they fucking work. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I know. I'm fucking annoyed. And this stuff here, I guess the hairstyle, hair costume, all that stuff's just genetic. Not fucking genetic. Cosmetic. I don't know about necklace and armband. I assume they actually provide stats, but I haven't gotten any yet, so I don't know. So we're going to go ahead and use the compass again. And it won't let me. So, yeah. What else can we look at? Inventory, classes, and skills. Adventure journal. This is kind of fun. As you do stuff, you gain points. You can trade these points in the hub city for prizes. I guess you'd call it that. Other than that, I don't really know how it works too well. Like, you get points for doing shit. Killing monsters. You have all these various, I guess, character stats. Fucking, god damn it. Piss off. I'm trying to buy time while the server catches up. Well, I can kill enemies, that's a good sign. Oops, I actually did not mean to do that. I want to put it into high anchoring. Which still isn't letting me take it, so we're going to switch channels again. And hope for the best. Welcome to day one. Tree of Savior. Now, technically, the game is supposed to be free to play. I paid the 10 bucks or whatever to get a month early access, but fortunately, it's been a pain in the ass. Oh, wait, we might have found a good channel. Hey, there we go. So we should be able to use the compass now. Okay. So far, so good. Let's use the compass again. Alright, good. Okay. Let's do shit while we still can. Check the map. We'll talk more about the other stuff in the game here in a little bit. So it looks like we need to go to District 4, which is right up this way. I'll show you more. There's probably a boss fight coming up, so that'd be a good place to show you some more of the combat. You can jump with the space bar, that's kind of cool. You usually don't see that in this type of games. It's usually just walk from A to B. There's a lot of invisible walls, you can't jump on everything, but in the hub city you can jump on roofs and stuff, so that's pretty cool. There's the purifier. I don't think we're actually supposed to do anything there. Before we go into our boss fight, let's see if we can finally take our high anchoring here. Hey, there we go. Don't know what it does. Aim with the tip of your arrow and penetrate through enemies in front of you. Okay. We'll give her a try. Alright, should be a boss fight here, I think. No, maybe not. Once again, sorry about the frame rate, but the game is not very well optimized. Okay, good. In lieu of actually getting experience points when you complete a quest, you get these little books here, or cards, I guess they're called. They're called experience cards, and you have to use them for your experience points. Why they added in the extra step, I do not know, but it works pretty much all the same. And we leveled up, so we can take a new status point, and we're going to go ahead and put it into dexterity. Yes. Alright, good. Alright, let's go ahead and try to examine this. It doesn't look like it's doing too much for me here. I don't know if I'm actually... Okay, once they move, now I'll know if it's gonna work or not. God damn, fucking... Click hitbox is in a weird place. Okay, so as far as I can tell, I'm not supposed to do anything at that one. So we'll go down to the silver flag, search District 6 for a part. Hopefully we'll get a boss fight there, because there have been a lot of boss fights in this dungeon so far. I'd like to show you at least one of them. To be fair, I am seriously overpowered right now. You level up really fast in this game. So, I think you're supposed to have a party while doing this dungeon, but I don't. Alright, we're going to ignore that purifier for now and go down here. Guess we're going down this way. Holy shit, this game is stuttering. I really wish I could find a way to record whenever I have the, For some reason, when you put this game in full screen mode, it goes into windowed full screen. And the only way to change that is by going into the config file. Oh, here we go. We got a boss. Okay. The stone left. Whenever you're fighting a boss, it goes into an instance mode, which you can see that you're in an instance mode in the top center of the screen with that little film reel. That means all the other players around you disappear. So I'm gonna go ahead and... Yep. As I suspected, this is gonna be an easy fight. Oh, I hit the rock. Holy shit, dude. Calm down. So let's try our new skill. Let's get some distance here and try the 7-key. It wasn't that great. My multi-shot's still by far the best move I have. Yep, he's dead already. Let's see if he drops any cool items. Hey, we got gems. Okay. Gems are used as, like... I don't know how to describe it. They're sock... Your weapons, your armors and stuff, you can add sockets to them. Then you can use a gem to... basically buff that stuff. You know how it works. You basically just socket the gem into the... said item, and then the item improves slightly. Okay, did that. Go ahead and use... Oops. Sorry. Let's go ahead and use our XP. What are some of these gems? Weapon of Freck. Weapon of Freck. Weapon effect, critical rate, +2. Maximum attack, +4. That one's a good one. Critical attack, +6. You can put them, I think you can put any gem on any piece of equipment you have on. Like, you can't, like, this yellow gem doesn't just go on weapons, you can put it on your boots or gloves or stuff, and each time, for each gem, it increases something different depending on the item you place it on. So you can see, if I put it on my top or my bottom, my physical defense would go up by 1, or if I put it on my boots, my HP would go up by 15. I imagine you just have to do trial and error. This little spinny thing here means that we're ready to turn in a quest, and the cool thing about this game is if you press the backspace key, you can actually teleport to where you turn in your quest, which I thought was kind of cool. Repairing the purifier. Alright, there we go. We got one more level 2. I don't know if that's enough to make us level up or not. If it works, almost. Very close. Like I said, you level up very fast in this game. I'm already level 4 Ranger, and I've only been playing as a Ranger for about, I don't know, half an hour. Because you level up your class and your character individually. Where are we going now? I'm going to have to take a look-see at the map here. We are going back up to District 4. There may be another boss fight incoming, I don't know. Fuck off, bats. Okie dokie. Wait, I'm just going here, right? Yeah, I'm going here. Follow the lead of the mine compass and find a way to remove the rust. Okay. That's not it. According to this, I should be... You hear sounds of working machinery, go to District 5. Okay, where's District 5 at? Way over there, so basically we ran around here for nothing.
Maniacs!
On a side note, the music's not bad in this game at all. I've only heard about 5 or 6 songs, but they've all been pretty good. Do not cast sleep on me. Oh, there's a chest here. We got a collection box. Collection boxes are kind of cool. When in an area, there's a collection box, and then you can put various items into that collection box by killing enemies. They're put in there automatically, but I think once you—I've never filled one up yet, but I imagine you get something whenever you do fill it up. I don't know if you get experience or an item or what. Am I going the right way? Is this District 5? It is District 5. Uh-oh. Easy there, game. That move I just used lets me move slightly faster. That's why I keep using it. It's not by much, but it does help a little bit to speed things along. So it looks like we're going up here. Ah, here we go. Oh, wait. There we go. Observing. We got the lubricant. Lube. Well, I guess we turn it in here, huh? Yeah, here. We'll just teleport back to where we're supposed to go. Son of a bitch. Fucking people in the way. There we go. Alright. Now activate the auxiliary purifier. We'll teleport straight to it. I was standing in front of it, was I not? Guess not. Okay, now we need to go to the third floor, which is way down here. As you can see, this doesn't really deviate too much from what you see in other MMOs. The game's fun, don't get me wrong. I know I sound kind of asshole. I know I sound kind of, like, irritated because just because I'm really irritated at the frame rate right now, because I usually do get 60 to 80. But when I switched back to the game's default configuration, it went to shit. And for some reason, the game will not record whenever I make it true full screen, and I don't know why that is. Oddly enough, you can't alt-tab out either whenever you're full-screened. I'm not really sure why that is either. Oh shit, we're going the wrong way. This dungeon, I've been in this dungeon for quite a while, so it should be about done. I would think so anyway. How the fuck do I get out here? Well, fuck. Can you piss off? Okay, it's not this way. This way either. This looks like a dead end to me. It's a dead end. I'm not really too worried about the mobs around here. They can't really hurt me that bad. Like I said, I am overpowered. I would assume dungeons are meant to be done in a group, but no point in me fucking around with a group if I don't have to. Plus, a lot of other people are in here by themselves, so it's all good. There's gotta be a fucking... Ah, here we go. Okay. There are these guys. Ah, you put me to sleep, you asshole. Get out of here. And we leveled up yet again. We will put this one into strength. I guess whenever you level up, it damages the enemies around you, too. I wasn't sure about that. I saw it earlier, and I wasn't sure if that's what was going on or not. We We are having server lag because the new zone should be loading right now, but it's not. Yep. Ah, there it is. Alright, here we go. Let's turn this in. I'm not reading all that. So, around the world, you will find these various goddess statues. There are 5 different goddesses, I think, and each one does something different. Most give you, like, a stat boost, but the goddess Vakarine actually works as a warp point. So, she allows you to teleport from one statue of hers to another. Or you could just use the teleport scrolls I have, I think. I don't know where they're at. I think they're in my inventory. Use these. Hey, class level up. Yeah, basic warp scroll. Lets you teleport to any one of her statues as well. Alright, let's take critical shot, even though I have no fucking clue what it does. Because Korean. Yep. Something, 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 131, something, 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 0%, then something, 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 62%. So, no idea what it does. We'll have to trial and error that one out. Well, these are new. I need to kill a couple of these, then. We got this. How big is this place? Looks pretty big, doesn't it? Oh, we fell. I don't think it really matters. We're searching for villagers right now, but we know exactly where they're at thanks to the minimap. I've been hatched. Oh, we got a new recipe as well. Yes, there is a crafting system. No, I have not used it yet. So I'm not even gonna bother talking about it, because what I say is probably gonna be completely wrong. Okay. Villagers, villagers. Oh, there they are. Oh, a chest too. We got an emoticon. That's new. Okay, so we saved the villagers. Yay! In a boss fight, maybe? No, just a swarm of spiders. Oh god, teleport there. Wow, that was awful easy, wasn't it? You only need to kill 7 of them. Alright, easy peasy lemon squeezy. We are done. We get 3 level 2 XP cards. Very nice. Check crystal pillar in the closed area. We shall do that in a moment. We got new boots as well. They are not all that great though. They reduce our stamina by 10 and SP by 17, but evasion, does go up. So we're not going to use those. We'll sell those. There is an auction house in the game that I have not used, so I am going to sell them to the vendor. Hopefully, if this ends soon, this dungeon, I can show you the hub city at a glorious 12 frames per second, I'm sure. Okay, what are we doing? Crystal wall. There seems to be a gap in the rock where you can insert something. We need bubby magic stones. Okay, so we need to kill some bubbies. The fuck are bubbies? Where do I find them? Are they going to appear? Well, I can't click it again, so I guess not. I guess we have to go find them. I think Vubbies are these little mages and shit. What are they called? These shamans? I don't know. We're gonna look. I can't find anything now, even though I was being swarmed with enemies a minute ago. Ah, here we go. There they are. Well, for whatever fucking reason, my skill didn't go off. We got one stone. Oh, there's another one. Alright. I am not gonna wait for them to spawn. Here's one. I'm gonna try to search them out. There was a group of them. I remember seeing them. Spiders don't care about. Come on, shaman. Don't make this difficult on me. I'm destroying those crystals because there's a stamina meter here. I never ran out of stamina yet, but when you do, evidently you can't run anymore or something. I don't know. Stamina really doesn't decrease that fast, so it's not a big deal. And those rocks are literally everywhere for you to destroy. I need to find some fucking shamans, though. Oh, another chest. What do we get this time? Collection box for the third floor. Oh, okay. Each floor has its own collection box. Did not know that. Everybody else is hunting shamans too, so now we get to compete with each other. Let's go back up here. Oh, we got people waiting here too. I am too slow. Ah, there's one. And it's not gonna matter because did I actually get one? No, did not. I need to stay out of those webs. Mine crystal. What's this do? Oh, I triggered a boss. Okay, that's kind of cool. Oh, I can't use it again. I guess we'll try our critical shot. 8. So I'm not too impressed with it because I'm not sure if I'm even using it right. Let's move away from that. This might finish him off. Yeah, there we go. Well, we got some superior boots. And we got a new monster card, which I don't know anything about the monster cards yet, but evidently you can play monster card game with some other players. I'm not really sure. Alright, let's check out these boots here. They are physical defense plus 2, evasion plus 6. I'd say that's probably worth it. What's this? Oh, let you. Whatever, it unlocked a new emoticon. And these are the monster cards. I don't know what they're really used for yet. All I remember is the game told me that they're used to play some kind of monster card game with other players. And of course I was attacking the fucking spider. Alright. I got 2 stones there. How many more do I need? 5. I think if I just spam my, not my oblique shot, my barrage. Whenever one spawns, I should be okay. because it fires instantly instead of me having to charge it up. This is not what I like about an MMO at all, having to fight over fucking enemies with the other players. Shit, come on, spawn already. Or not. Hey, there's one. Four more. At this rate, we'll be done in about 20 minutes. Alright, so I can kill them in one hit if I spam my, or use my third attack, which is good. Oh, here we go. Okay, nice. Alright, got them all. So, let's move on. Insert bubble magic stones into crystal wall. We shall do as such. And it went kaboom, which means we can progress forward. Maybe. Oops, I hit a loading zone. Okay. We'll use our experience card. What's gonna happen down here? Gotta be pretty goddamn close to the end. Boss fight? Got dramatic music. Must be a boss fight. We got bats. We got pissed off bats. Oh, here we go. Murtis. Alright, Murtis. Let's do it. Well, you are not very strong, are you? Oh! Oh! I don't know if I actually dodged that. Was I supposed to jump over it? Is he gonna keep doing that, or can I... Alright, I think we're good to attack. Wow, he's almost dead already. And he's finished. Easy peasy. So, I don't know if they get harder if you have more people in your party. That would make sense because that was super easy for me solo. Incompatibility. Each monster has an element and defense property. Element attributes have the following compatibilities. Okay. Ice attacks are effective against fire, so pretty much Pokemon. Okay, got it. Hey, we can... Oh, we got three status points. Nice. We'll put one in constitution, one in strength. That'll do, says the pig. And then... Got eight of these. We're gonna level up again. And we class leveled up as well. Nice. Like I said, you level up super, super duper fast in this game. We got a new bangle, and it's really not that great. We got some weapons we can't use. We could take physical defense down by two for a plus eight invasion. Evasion, not invasion. That sounds like a good deal to me. These are recipes we can learn. You already know that recipe. Okay, nice. So let's level up our class skill. We're gonna put more into Barrage because that's a badass skill. And we're gonna put another point into Dexterity. Alright, and we're ready to turn in this quest from the mine. Hopefully I'll be able to show you the hub city here soon. Actually, I think we're going to the hub city right now. I think this is where this guy's at. Yep, okay, we're in the hub city. So let me turn this in. Yep. What? Oh, okay, I was just lagging a bit. And this guy can create a guild, which I have not done. So, let's take a little tour. As you can see, the FPS is not that great here, but it hasn't been great at all. We have our Ranger Master, who's our master. And she can teach us various new attributes, which change some things. What's odd about these is sometimes some of them take some time to learn. Like, if I want to learn the weapon swap, I can, if it'll work. Yeah. And now I can't learn another attribute till that one's done, so I have to wait a minute. So in the meantime, we're going to take a look-see around. Attributes aren't skills you can use, they're kind of like passive stuff. I'm not really even sure what the one I picked does, it just says weapon swap, but maybe it means like in the middle of battle or something. Let's see. The Krivik. Krivis Master. Probably some class trainer. These are all masters here. They're marked by red. So let's take a look at some stuff. This is our adventure woman. She gives us stuff for doing various things. I'll take the... Oh, look at all these prizes we got. I'll take that. I don't know if it's lagging from... Okay. There we go. Yeah, it's just taking time. She gives you money for doing various things. Like, the adventure stats, 804 over 2,000. I don't know what the fuck that means. So for doing achievements, you get shit. Quests, I got 170 of 200 before I hit level 3, then I get more. I don't know. But I did get a decent amount of money, didn't I? Yeah, I have 30k now. I'm saving up for a companion, a beast to come with me, but they're 110k. So let's take a look down here. Like I said, you can jump on the roofs of buildings. That's kind of cool. You don't have to walk the whole way around. That's our storage keeper. Works as a bank. You know how that works. Market manager is our auction house, I do believe. Yep, sure is. I don't have anything I need. TP trader is our TP... type deal. You don't know what TP is, that's your microtransaction bullshit. So you can buy TP with real money, then spend it on cosmetic shit or experience boosts or whatever. As far as I can tell, it's not pay to win, which I like. At least not yet. I mean, you can get these experience boosts and mostly it's all cosmetic stuff, but it's not pay to win, which is what I really worry about in a free-to-play game. And you have Lyanna who's saying, no data, quest something something. Who is broken? Okay. We have our blacksmith who will repair our armor for us. You can also socket our gems into our various equipment. Let's go ahead and see if we can't do that. Oops. We have some server lag. Okay. So, for example, let's say we wanted to put... What's a good one for our bow? Let's put maximum attack 4, plus 4, on our bow if we can. I haven't done this yet, so I don't know if it'll work. Do I need to drag it over here? I haven't done this yet, so I don't know what I'm doing. And it went bye-bye. Why did it go bye-bye? There it is. So we need to add a socket to it. Really? 656 gold for a socket? Okay, fine. my gosh, server, you are pissing me off. You are absolutely fine up until when I wanted to do something interesting. Nope. Not gonna happen. Okay. Let's put my bow back on at least. Oh, I can't even put my bow back on. Can we change channels? Oh, wow, these channels are super full. Let's go 17. Hopefully this will work because I want to know how to socket gems anyway. Oops, I just fired out at random. Watch out, people. Okay, socket management. Very good. Let me take this over here, right? Yes, no, maybe. Wait. There we go. We add a socket. Yes. Okay, evidently not. I'm doing it right. I mean, there's no other option. I'm just trying to add a socket. That's all I want to do. Well, once again, this problem falls into day one. And the server's being complete and utter shit right now. That's not fair. I don't know if they're complete and utter shit or this. Perhaps maybe the game devs just didn't expect this many people. I don't know. What's this? I don't know what that is. That's new. Competitive mission, start unit, guild, protect the goddess. I don't have a guild though. I thought maybe it was a guild invite, but it doesn't look like it. Oops, that's not the right person. Okay, I want to go to the item merchant and sell some shit. I need to sell all three of these. Thank you. Are you actually going to give me the money? Not quite yet. Oh, there they go. We can get rid of those. And we'll keep those just in case we want to switch back. Don't need those. Don't need those. Accessory can go. I'm at 32% of my max weight, so I can still carry a lot more. What's this? There are legal word. Oh, legal. How about a legible? Legible words written on it. Very well then, motherfuckers. What's this? What the hell is this shit? Oh, that's my attribute, I bet. So I can hot swap weapons out during battle. Okay, I see what it did. Okay, that makes more sense. I'm less critical of it now. So we're gonna try socket management since it seems like the servers are acting normal. Ish. Maybe not at all. Yeah, not at all. Oh, there it goes. Okay, now we need to add a socket. We'll just wait. We'll wait. We'll give it a minute or two here. See if it decides it wants to add the socket or not. Come on, please work. Okay, so it's not gonna work. Alright, guys. So, this has been day one of Tree of Savior. I almost forgot the game of the name of the game. The game's fun. It's really fun. I enjoyed it. I'm gonna play it more, but I'm not gonna make another video till these servers, like, stop being so ridiculous. I can't say whether or not jump into the game early or not, spend the $10, $30, or $50 for the early access pass. I need to see how the servers go, but as of now, don't do it. Wait for the servers to even out. But the game's fun. I'm tired. I spent not three, that's a lie. I spent 2 hours in the queue initially trying to log in, and then the game crashed, and when I came back in, it let me log in automatically, but then the servers kept going down, and I kept getting disconnected, and before I knew it, I was 3 hours later and already level 20-something, and then I finally decided to record this video. So, yep, that's been my experience so far. Hopefully, before next time, I'll be able to figure out the frame rate issue. I know the frame rate issue. Hopefully, I'll be able to figure out why I can't alt-tab out whenever I have the frame rate issue resolved to actually start the recording equipment. But that's all I got for now, guys. I will make another video of this game, I promise. Just give me some time to let the servers even out here and stop acting so stupid. He buffed me. What'd he do? I don't know what he did. There was a little thing there, and I missed it. Alright, but before I go on another tangent, that's all I got, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you soon.